Welcome to another Facebook Live. Only this time, we're not in the pastor's office, we're down here in the chapel. So Austin and I are here together. Austin is the director of chapel worship music, and I just wanted to get together and talk to you about, we talked, I think it was last week or the week before, to Jana and sanctuary worship and music, and so I wanted to get together with Austin. We are so excited about the way God has blessed us with this space and the way the people have responded to worship in this space under your leadership. So how's it going so far? Are you feeling all right about it?
Yeah, well, like launching anything new, it's always a lot of unknown. You never know what could happen, but you have a big grand vision and you hope and you dream and you pray and things launch and we were successful. No major crash and burn. And I think things are going well. We've had some good positive responses about the things that have been happening in that space.
I mean, we are still looking for some volunteers, right? Yep. Some volunteers to help with like setting up communion, and you need some volunteers connected to some other things as well. Some people out at the door, some people to direct folks, and right, some stuff like that. Yep. But I'm really, really excited. 9:15 and 11 o'clock worship services on Sunday morning here in the chapel. We're off to a great start. So, but there's more about this than just a worship service, right? I mean, you are after, it's your heart goal and dream for this to be a lifestyle, right? So tell us about that.
Yeah, so this idea of a lifestyle of worship, something that goes beyond just Sunday morning, just beyond the weekend experience, something that can engage people on a Monday through Saturday during their week, and daily devotion, daily worship, daily participation in that, creating a habit and really changing their lifestyle to be something that's daily engaged. All for the sake of the weekend experience being something where you're worshiping shoulder to shoulder with people who have worshiped Monday through Saturday in preparation for the weekend. And I think that we're going to see a change in the spiritual growth and the worship response in this whole body worship, full participation of this lifestyle worship. So that's bigger than just Sunday morning.
Yeah, and so you've got, so there's an app, right? There's an app. So tell us about the app. What do you got on the app, and what are the tools that the people can use for the sake of this weekly lifestyle?
Yeah, so the app has all of our announcements, anything that's going on in the church that we can kind of save some time from spending it on stage, trying to announce it all in person. It's also a reference so that, you know, I don't know if somebody tells me top of that, the app also features all the songs for the coming weekend. Again, intentionally trying to get people to engage in their worship life. And with each of the songs, I post about almost like a daily devotion or a thought around each song so that we have this. And I share it with the band too, even the band and the people who are practicing and leading the worship. We are all doing these devotions together so that the music is more than just some songs on a weekend, but it's actually this experience in worship that we engage in daily, and that prepares our hearts for worship. Something that goes beyond the habitual and into something spiritual.
So think about that. As we get ready for chapel worship every week, you can go on this app and you can, one song a day, and that song's going to be played in worship that next weekend. You can learn it, get into it, you can understand it more, and it's going to mean more to you when you do sing it in worship. And then there's devotional thought from Austin there so that you can really prepare yourself for what's about to happen. And then when you're in the event, you're going to get so much more.
Yeah, so yeah, it changes your perspective, and it changes this idea of I'm going to come sometimes on a Sunday morning, we come to get something out of worship. And so it kind of changes our worship mindset from this spectator mentality. And by worshiping Monday through Saturday in preparation, it changes us to a participator mentality. And I think that's that's really important for a movement in worship life. The more we can get people to participate in worship, the more they can have a spiritual experience. And instead of spending a lot of time teaching the songs every weekend to try to learn, especially since we're new and we're creating this new contemporary, state-of-the-art, latest and popular Christian music, not everybody knows it and has access to it or is familiar with it. And so instead of spending a lot of time teaching it on Sunday morning, we do that through the app and we do that through the pre-week set list that way so that people are prepared on the weekend.
One of the things that I've noticed is that there are some of the things that you guys, that you're leading us to do in worship here in the chapel that, you would hear on like K-Love and places like that, but there's stuff that's newer than that. There's stuff that's not on that playlist. And so having that opportunity is really, really cool to dive in, know the music, so that you can know how to participate. We've also talked about, and we've gone past one of them now, and so it was kind of the beginning, but we've also talked about like these fifth Sundays, right? These fifth Sundays for Chapel North are going to be, our hope is that these are going to be really cool experiences. So tell us about your heart when it comes to those kinds of things.
Yeah, so we have a big church. We have a lot of people who attend, and we are already doing a lot of great things in mission. So one thing, the app is going to help us remind us the things that we're doing in mission, how people can get involved. The other thing is on this fifth Sunday, it gives us the opportunity to mobilize these people, to mobilize the church into giving action to those mission things. It would be a wasted opportunity not to. And so these fifth Sundays, we have the opportunity to mobilize our people to do something in the community, to serve, to do outreach, and to better our community.
Yeah, very cool. So, if you were going to, first of all, our target audience, if you will, is anybody who wants to be with us. But one of the things that we've really been pressing in on, in both rooms, is to invite. And one of the things that I think is really important for us now that we've launched is when we say invite to the people in this room, we're not talking about inviting people from the other room to this room, right? We're talking about, in my mind, so fill in on this. In my mind, it's four basic kinds of groups of people. It's people who don't know Jesus and don't have any experience with church, people who have become disillusioned with the institution of the church and they're looking for more family connection and movement and opportunity, people who are at other different churches but they're looking for something different and new. Our hope is that they're going to invite those kinds of people, right? Mm-hmm. So how would you say those kinds of things?
Yeah, I mean, early on we talked a lot about having something that's just really not abrasive, comfortable. So we kind of have this theme of this come-as-you-are, blue-jean kind of crowd. We don't expect anybody to dress up for church or wear their Sunday best. Again, coming back to this worship lifestyle, what does your life look like Monday through Saturday? Dress like that,
yeah.
Worship like that, and then let this Sunday morning experience speak for itself. And then statistically, we've talked a lot about, when we were talking about the vision and the hope for this as we were developing it, young people are leaving the church, and that's a national statistic, and we're no exception to that. And so to create something that is comfortable and is inviting to people who are de-churched or disillusioned, is really important as well.
Yeah. So, kind of last thing, we've launched this now, and we've been into this for a little while now, a couple of months. So what would you share with the people who are going to watch this about your heart for their participation in this room when we worship?
For those who want to check us out or have been coming, continue to do so, but utilize the app. I mean, it's a tool. It is an opportunity. It is something that's really going to greatly increase your worship experience on the weekend. that's the only hour you worship in a week, yeah, no wonder, right? Yeah. We want something that's an experience, that is a lifelong thing. So utilize the app. I would say that's really, really important. Invite is going to be really important. And because we've created this atmosphere that is Come As You Are and is this Blue Jean crowd, the people who have been coming have said really great things about, oh, this is something I could invite my coworker to, and it would not feel awkward or weird to invite somebody to church. It would feel normal and natural because we're doing something, we're experiencing something in this place. So I think those are two really important things for this space.
So as we close, I would just also add in to that you know what, when you really think about the heart of this, the goal is that this would be a new mission start. Mm-hmm. And so the people who come to a new mission start can't be consumers. We got to all be in it together, and we've got to all participate and dive in order to build up the kingdom, frankly. There are people who come from unbelief to faith and find their way through life because we do this kind of thing together. But it's only going to be as good as the number of people who dive in, participate the way Austin needs us to. And God blesses that, and it really makes a difference in people's lives. So thanks. Have a great day.